The Sahara is transforming. Should we be worried or filled with hope? The Sahara, the world's largest desert, stretches across West Africa. Although deserts are usually characterized by a dry climate and limited vegetation, there has been a reversal in recent years as the Sahara is becoming greener, largely due to the effects of climate change. The shift from brown to green. During the monsoon season from July to September, rainfall in northern Africa increases. This happens when tropical air near the equator meets warm, dry air coming from the north of the continent. This area of convergence is called the Intratropical Convergence Zone, or ITCZ. The ITCZ shifts further north during the Northern Hemisphere summer months and descends south during the warm Southern Hemisphere months, according to CNN. However, recent global warming has caused the ITCZ to move further north, explained Karsten Haustein, a climate researcher at the University of Leipzig. This year, that shift has made the Saharan region 2 to 6 times wetter than normal. Areas with the greatest increase in vegetation. This year, the largest increases in vegetation were seen in southern Chad, southern Sudan, and Eritrea. In particular, regions of Mali, Niger, Chad, Sudan, and Eritrea experienced a significant increase in rainfall. A sudden burst of vegetation followed a supertropical cyclone that affected the northwestern Sahara on September 7th and 8th, bringing heavy rainfall to areas that rarely receive moisture, according to NASA's Earth Observatory. What is also striking is that the normally dry lakes in the Sahara are filling with water because of this phenomenon, said Moshe Armon, a senior lecturer at the Earth Science Institute. Climate consequences and prospects. The northward shift of the ITCZ and the increase in vegetation in the Sahara may be related to two main causes: the transition from El Niño to La Niña and worsening climate change. El Niño, a natural climate phenomenon associated with warmer temperatures in the equatorial oceans, often leads to drier conditions in many parts of West and Central Africa. Conversely, La Niña can cause more rainfall. Climate change is warming the region, causing the ITCZ to shift to higher latitudes. In addition, increasing CO2 emissions from fossil fuels may cause more frequent ITCZ shifts, according to a study published in the journal Nature. The interaction between climate change and the ITCZ. Climate change not only affects the ITCZ, but the ITCZ itself can have climate effects. Recent Saharan vegetation may be linked to a quieter period of tropical storms in the Atlantic. As tropical waves originating from the ITCZ head further north into the Atlantic Ocean than usual, they encounter cooler air and water, which may limit the potential for storm development, notes the Washington Post. However, increased rainfall has put 4 million people in 14 countries at risk, according to the World Food Organization. While some areas receive more rain than normal, others suffer from drought. Every single event is affected by climate change, Haustein said.